Hello, my name is the Big Jimmy, and I am going to play the Splatoon. Oh boy!
So yeah, I was completely distracted by Zelda, and only yesterday did I notice. Oh hey, there's a big run going on in Splatoon. I should do my monthly revisit for the various Splatfest and big runs. So here we go. Temporary map for Big Run or Salmon Run. Okay, I saw it was under Toad Spillway, but honestly the names don't matter that much to me. Also, isn't this usually everything's all dark? I can't see this far normally. I didn't realize it was just a bunch of columns. Forgive me if I make some mistakes or anything, because I have no idea where like baskets are on this map. There's nothing to see through. Completely unrelated to this game or anything going on in the news or anything like that. But I'm gonna rant about something for just a quick sec. Video game done by Life Reformers things. I was watching this while eating my dinner, or actually doing other things, just before going live. And it's a nice little, you know, nostalgia to go back and see, you know, old NES, or SNES, NES, even PlayStation and 64 games done in a more symphonic way, getting the big orchestra and band together. But all of those songs, typically, in that period of video games, was usually designed to either be like a traditional orchestra piece, or it was designed around some kind of like rock music. Like, Capcom obviously wanted to do like rock music with its, sound box. Meanwhile, a lot of Nintendo stuff was definitely more about big band music stuff. And, you know, we know what they were supposed to sound like. Hearing those songs being realized fully by large bands and stuff like that is great. But, like I said, it's kind of easy to know what these songs were supposed to sound like. So then it comes time to, like, okay, let's put this song together. And okay, so wood instruments. are we using in this song to replicate the sounds of, you know, the old SNES sound chip and stuff like that. Anyway, okay, this part was clearly supposed to have string instruments. Okay, we'll get the violins, the cello, and whatnot to do that. And, oh, this high-pitched noise that was, like, leaving the melody. Oh, that's clearly a flute. You know, or, you know, where you play, like, a Mega Man, and you always hear that, like, strumming rhythm going on. Like, that's clearly supposed to be an electric guitar. And so, and usually, they do that. They're like, okay, this song is going to be led by electric guitar. This song's, you know, oh, that's the backing there. That's not a, you know, a giant gong playing in the background. That's a drum kit playing in the background. Okay, we'll give that to the drum. And then, and usually, like I said, they're right. And then you get the ones where they just get it so very fucking wrong. And it pisses me off to no end. So I was just listening to the live band. Was called something along the lines of Songs from Our Sound, or Our Save Files. And they did Chrono Trigger. And I was like, oh, sweet, I love my Chrono Trigger music. And one of my favorite songs started up called World Revolution. It's the second to last, like, final boss. The first final boss is a three different song. Yeah, okay, I think it's... Got it down by one. Get down by one! Go, go, go! Anyway, so... The song is very clearly an orchestrated song, but this big band has an electric guitar in it, a guy with drums, keyboardist, yada yada, and the song starts off heavily with the synth keyboard, and I'm like, ugh, that doesn't sound quite right, but whatever, this is their interpretation, it doesn't ruin the song, but then it gets to a part in the song. It might just be easier if I do, like, genuinely play it for you. Give me a sec. Let's see. Give me a sec. So this is what this sound like on the SNES. Okay, so that's what it sounded like. And these guys, and very clearly at the beginning, you hear a sound that sounds like a French horn. And very clearly is trying to mimic a French horn. And then I just realized you're not hearing this at all. I have to actually set up the capture for my desktop audio. And unfortunately, now I'm in a Mac, so I can't do it. So, whoopsie. Anyways, it's the part of the song that clearly sounds like it has a French horn. And it's coming up in the live performance. And what do I get but the fucking electric guitar playing that part of the song? And it's just one of those things like, what the fuck is this? You just had to get a horn, a brass, to play this part. And it would have been perfect. And it's one of the things I've noticed a shit ton is anytime there's a live performance of video game music, and they've got an electric guitar in the band, at some point, that guy just gets to, like, run free. No other instrument gets to do this. For some reason, everyone else in the large orchestra understands we are part of something larger. We are working together to make something bigger sounding. Except Mr. Electric Guitar. Mr. Electric Guitar gets to be the star of the show. He's Mr. Cool Guy. and gets to make whatever stupid choices he wants and dance around on stage like he's fucking in AC/DC. I don't know where my wave breaker went. I threw that shit out. Anyways, yeah, that. Let's see if I can configure it. Okay, so you guys should be able to. Yeah, that main instrument there. Did that sound like an electric guitar? Did that sound like a fucking electric guitar? I don't think it did. And these fucking D-bags, I hate to get all mad about this because they actually did a good job for the most part. Let me see if I can actually find that. And so here's the live version. So yeah, that keyboard comes in. Doesn't sound like what's in the original song, but that one's fine. That one I'm open for interpretation. But then, let's see. Fine. Yes, I'm delaying my game to make this point. For that guy. And of course, the guy with the electric guitar then, like, comes out center stage and is, like, in front of the fucking orchestra. And this is constantly a thing. Like, if you want to see, like, the perfect example of this, the electric guitar is basically showboating. Several performances of One Winged Angel from Final Fantasy VII. Overuses the electric guitar to such a degree, and that song was never designed to use an electric guitar. That was a big orchestral piece. It was very obvious, even the MIDI at the time was capable of replicating a form, generally what the song was supposed to sound like. But nope, they just love throwing in that electric guitar into these orchestrated pieces, and I just don't know why. If you're gonna do Capcom music, yes, by all means, include an electric guitar. Capcom was the basis. The electric guitar was the foundation of Capcom music. But when it comes to shit like Square Enix, no. They were all orchestra. They never designed around an electric guitar. What? Did I not pick up an egg? I'm standing right on it. I'm getting too sidetracked with my little rant. Anyways, yeah, fucking... Anytime you do these stupid... like... video games come to life things, please be smart with your, like, instrument choices. I know you've gotten a guy with electric guitar there, but that doesn't mean you should just give him random parts. up that air can be shit. So we're in a bit of the not E3 E3, the Schrodinger's E3. It's alive, but it isn't. Woo! I did pretty bad there. But then again, I seem to be the one focusing on actually getting rid of the things that's killing us, as always in Salmon Run. But yeah, it looks like we're seeing a bit of the lump that without having the actual E3 event to base everything around, like, information has been pretty much a drip feed as far as gaming news goes, and that's fine. It's probably better for us in the long run that things are presented when they're done rather than we have to meet E3 because E3 exists. If a game isn't finished, fine. Keep it on the burner, let it keep getting worked on. Don't try to make it in time for some sort of press junket. But that also means, yeah, for us consumers, it means just sitting back and just kind of hoping fun stuff's happening. A little bit more. I did take some notes in some of the presentations the other day. I plan on going over them with Ryan tomorrow on the screen. But, presented, like, yeah, we're supposed to have something to show off, but here's this. Thank you. damn it.
I heard a lot of people getting pissed off because of the weapon random selection in this mode, and I can kind of get it, but I wouldn't want to be stuck with a weapon set. Could figure out something you're gonna want to play extensively since you're competing. So I don't blame people for getting mad that they have to deal with random weapons. I just wouldn't want to deal with having one set of weapons this entire time. To my desktop. But what am I supposed to do? It's a waiting time. Waiting for the next match. Entertain myself. I know that I'm a zoomer, everyone! I need constant news and information being fed in my fucking skull. Just survive, 3 seconds. Tears in my brain. Buddy, shoot these. Thank you. We'll be right back. center stage? Oh, good, good. It's not good enough to just win. You gotta win by like a ridiculous amount. Otherwise, you're stuck with the fucking bronze reward. Boys. Yeah, I may be a little rusty, but come on. We can get at least one boss done tonight. That would be nice. Kill.
Oh,
Unfortunately, as always, Big Run brings out a lot of people who don't play Risk or Sandworm that much. And because of that, they don't have a lot of experience using the weird weapons. And so the sniper guy who has an overpowered sniper rifle was not using it to its maximum capacity. Oh, well. Great, it's just fantastic. Yep, there's a loss. Thanks to whoever fucking disconnected on us. Pickle him? Pickle him left. 21 watching, vote ban pickle him. Oh wait, Addy Lobo. I guess pickle him left in the last game and I didn't catch it. Never mind, pickle him is innocent. Do not ban pickle him. Pickle him is a good boy. I put myself in a bad position, man. I'm gonna go. many people. Oh, boom! Throwing that out there for anyone playing fucking Salmon Run. If you want to get revived, and someone's clearly shooting at you to revive you, don't move! Executive VP anytime soon. Better than what normally is expected from Salmon Run. Hopefully I can end the night at least at 100 points for the high score. Usually it's just over 100 is what I get, and so I'm always getting like silver trophies if anything. But this map does not lend itself to like rapid recovery when it comes to the A's. There's lots of little vertical leaps. Charger, okay. That many guns.
I got
Let's go! You fucked up!
You know, it'd be really nice for these big run maps if they actually incorporated some of the single player gimmicks into them. Some of the various like moving platforms and things you can activate to do stuff. Because just converting a standard multiplayer like a versus mode map into the co-op map, yeah. Already. It's an okay mode. It does not unfortunately thing as good as this flat mode. Aside from when they add the forward board, so it's a one time, and that's because hey, we got a new boss. If they're adding new bosses to each big map or a new map. Because they did just add a new Sam run map. But they don't know why they just saved that for the next big run. For the next one.
Big run! Almost 40's not bad.
But getting to 40 would be good.
Ooh, another of my favorites. Now it'll look even worse on this side.
What the fuck happened there?
Sacrifice. There we go, over 100. That's the kind of shit I want to see. That's right, I'm the weakest link. Fuck yeah. Everyone's carrying my ass. I'm a piece of shit. Get up. And of course, everyone fails. Oh, sure, we got a good high score of 104, but the moment there's a failure, it's like, well, bleh, I'm bailing. Everyone fucked up except me. Don't mind me, just slow walking. Alright. No! Fuck. Yeah, I should have used my special more. Always the curse of Salmon Run. Everyone's got super moves, but barely anyone touches them. Almost to another boss Salmonid, so we'll get that in. And how far are we along? Just over an hour. Yeah, I was planning on only going maybe an hour and a half, so we'll see how far we can get. Already that's a decent high score. That's probably gonna guarantee me a silver. I don't, but that fire rate just kills me. Please, not a blast. Okay, this is good. Thank you. 3 are a problem. I know I'm reminding you is so important if you let 3 eggs just walk right past you. The moment he's gone for sure is the moment I... Nope, he's still in, but I'm still in. If I could rely on him, for a solid run. I mean, he's got all the bad. Stop with the blasters! Just any plain ass shooter, I would be happy with.
need. We just need one. Ooh. Hey, what did I say? A nice basic ass blast. Going all the way over there. Fucking madman. It worked. But it was stupid. Didn't beat him last time. Maybe we can do it this time. Alright, there's a roller. No, I don't think that's what I'm saying. Thank you.
break the spell and start shooting the boss.
Stop moving, you fucking idiot!
Oh, this is gonna go through. Yeah, I'll go over here. Not that we haven't been successful, we just haven't been super successful. Things up trash. That's why I'm always like one point five times more trash picking up than anyone else. I'm the only one who ever fucking does it. Torn is still in. I'm still in. Shit. He's not in. Got my boy with me, then I don't know how much longer. Gross. There's only two fucking snipers here. Oh, okay, I can't stand it. The YouTuber is going to be special. sniper with two sniper rifles. Okay, that is way too close. There's no prep time for us. We might win just by having that's stupid. Because, yeah, we gave up our surplus eggs. We got as far as we did because somebody better than us was playing, so with that, I will call it an evening, and I will probably go take a nasty poop, and we will be live tomorrow, Sunday. Usual games of Startup Space Marine. Didn't mean to come back to that. Hopefully finishing Crimson Skies. And continuing Freedom Force versus the Third Reich. So, see you there. Goodbye. Have a wonderful evening.